Hey everybody, well Professor Tamara Hawkins here, but I go by Shawnee Scott in the radio world where I've been working for 24 years, and this class is just so amazing because it is really pushing me to reach outside of my normal boundaries. This was a very interesting project, picking a tool to use because being in the business so many years and knowing so many people, I've always been able to call on someone to do things like this for me. So with this class, I'm being forced to actually learn how to use the tools myself. So this is interesting. And I chose Adobe Spark because this is one that I'm afraid of. A lot of the Adobe platforms, I don't know, their tools scare me a little bit. So I decided I wanted to jump in and learn some interesting things about Adobe Spark and see if I can actually start using it without getting frustrated and giving up, because that's usually what happens. Okay. Adobe Spark is a production tool, and with this tool you can make videos, you can make postcards, you can make any kind of digital image that you want to use on any social media platform to help build your brand. So I found out that it's really not as hard as I thought it was. There's a simple 1-2-3 process. Number one, upload your logo or your image that you want to use. Number two, pick the colors that you want for your branding project. Now, how simple is that? And number three, this is the hardest one. The hardest one of them all is to pick the font that you want on your project. Simple as 1-2-3. And once you put those three elements into place, you click a button, and it creates everything for you. There are different layouts for you to choose from. And I was amazed because I was like, oh my God, this looks like the flyers that I paid a guy $40 to create for me. That's just to create the visual, not to print them for me. So I was really excited once I found out how easy it was when I sat down and took the time to learn how to use it. And speaking of time, it doesn't take that much time. I may have spent a good 7 minutes just going through reading what to do and how to use them before I got into it. And then once I got into it, oh, I was creating everything. I have so many things that I'm ready to post on social media now. Okay, once you sign up with Adobe Spark, you do have to sign up. Like I said, you have to create an account. And you can do that by using a username, creating that. You can use your email address, or you can use one of your social media platforms, Facebook. You can click on the Facebook symbol, and that will create you an account. Now, there are three different plans, just like it's three easy steps. Well, they have three easy plans for you to choose from. The first plan is free, and with that, you can do everything. You can do everything. You can create your branding story, a video, a digital image, or a web page. You can do all of that with the free package. Now, also with the free package, you have the capability to sync all of your projects together from your desktop to your iPhone to your iPad. And for it to be free, that's really cool. Now, the next plan that they have is $9.99 a month, and that's for the individual. Now, with that, you get everything that you get in the free plan, but you also get support. Also with the $9.99 plan, you can change out the Adobe Spark logo, because, you know, sometimes when you work on things and they have their logo there and you can't take it off, well, if you go ahead and pay for it, then you can remove their logo and put yours there. You can also customize the colors in the $9.99 package to match your brand exactly the way you want it. And on top of that, you get support. Now, plan three is $19.99 a month, and that's recommended for small businesses, teams, groups, medium-sized businesses. Now, with this, like I said, it's $19.99 a month. You get all of the features that were mentioned in package two and one, but this one is going to allow you to have ownership of the license. Their desktop support is also 24/7, so you can contact them 24/7 by phone, email, chat. They're there to help you. Now, all plans, I gave you prices for all plans monthly, but you can also pay for it annually as well, and there is a slight discount there with that. As I mentioned earlier, with Adobe Spark, there's so many different things that you can create. You can create your Facebook posts, your Facebook memes, your Twitter headers, postcards, business cards, videos. It's unlimited what you can create. I enjoyed sitting there just making a flyer for an event that I have coming up. It was, the filters were there for me to switch out and make the pictures look different, and it really looked nice and professional and not like Shawnee Scott had made it homemade and just patched some things together. So I'm really excited about learning how to use this new tool and to be able to implement it in the things that I already do every day. Plus, I'm going to save some money because now I know how to do it myself, and all I have to do is just spend a little bit more time with it to get to a point, to a level where I'm above novice, because we're not going to say expert. The feature that I found to be most beneficial with this is the three-step process, because like I said, for me, it's intimidating. I know people think I'm in my 20s, but I'm 41. You know, I started in radio when I was 17, and things are different. So as we have experienced this change, this digital change in the media world, for some of us, it's been hard to adapt to. People like me, you know, I've just tried to go with the flow, and I've been able to fake it till I make it because I knew people that could do these things for me. But coming in with a three-step process where, hey, just put a picture up here, pick a color that you want, and pick your text, that was easy as pie. So I think that's the most beneficial tool that they have in it. And then once you pick those three items and you're actually in your project and you're working on it, the tools that you use inside, like maybe if you want to change the color of a certain box, it's so simple because there are some words there, but for the most part, they're pictures. So if you don't understand the words, you definitely should be able to understand the pictures. So it's really an easy process. Something that I was afraid of, that I was just so afraid of, I found to be really easy and very useful. The only thing that I would say is missing from this is a person to actually do it for you. I mean, I can't stress enough how easy it was. And if you know me, and I don't know if I've gotten it over to you how afraid I was to use this. And the Adobe products is just something that has been a fear of mine because I never thought that I would be able to do it. And what I found out is that it wasn't that I couldn't do it, it's just I didn't take the time out to do it. So you have to have some patience when you are creating. You know, I'm used to getting in front of the microphone just saying what I have to say, and then I send that audio to somebody and they do whatever they need to do in production. I'm not the producer. You know, only of my show am I the producer. So if you have the time and you want it done right, all you have to do is sit down with the program and get it done. So I can't think of anything else that they could add to it other than a person to do it for you. It's really as simple as 1, 2, 3. Now, the other programs that I've used that's similar to this is CorelDRAW. And I use Google Slides, but I would say CorelDRAW. And you're probably like, you use CorelDRAW, but you're scared of Adobe? Yes, this is why. Okay? I was introduced to CorelDRAW in the 90s. So I've just been using it so long. Every time an update comes out, a new version comes out, I always get it. So I'm comfortable with it. That's what I came up with when I was sitting here thinking about this project, is because you're comfortable with it. So I just have to do the same thing with Adobe Spark and the other programs that are here and that are new that we're using if I want to continue to work and collect a check in media, that is. I just have to take the time out to familiarize myself with the product and the tools and use them. Just practice, you know. When it's time for a flyer to be made or I need a visual for my Facebook or my social media, my Instagram, then I should just take the time out and make it myself so that I'm more familiar with the product, and then I'll be as comfortable with Adobe Spark as I am with CorelDRAW.